Joining us today are the leading ladies of Kehne Ko Humsafar Hai. We have Anjali Singh and we have Gurjit with us. About the show, I want to say that the past two seasons have gotten some good responses on All Balaji, and now we're seeing the third season. But do you guys see something like this, the sort of modern relationship, dysfunctional family setup on TV?
No. I don't think so. Not for some time. You know, I will tell you, I was doing a show on a channel simultaneously while my web series was on, and I was playing the similar matured love story even there and on my web show. The channel were confused. They did not even want to explore that content, and they just put an axe to it. And the other side, the same time when I'm doing a super hit show on a web platform. So that's the difference we are talking about. These two platforms can never meet. They can never think alike.
Mona, we've also seen you in like a meaty role. If you talk about Justin, and for that time, it was quite forward, you know, for a woman to have stories revolve around her. But, you know, when we see TV, we see that, you know, a show sort of stretches on for like 500 episodes, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 episodes. Do you see yourself doing that again?
Very clearly, I don't see myself doing that anymore. I can't be on a same set for more than 3 months or 4 months. I don't have the patience anymore. But never say never. I might be doing a TV show soon. But I can't imagine myself playing the same character for 3 years, 5 years. It's very boring.
For an actor who has been experienced and has been around, who's given iconic shows, it's quite soul-crushing to do television. But sometimes you do it because that's your bread and butter. You are an actor. That's your job. We are not doing this because hobby turned into a profession, but we are living out of it. So then, yeah, you can never say never.
You, Gurdeep, we've seen Sanjeevani. Like, people still talk about Dr. Juhi, you know. But then again, like, the show sort of stretched on for a really long time, and you're still balancing, you know, TV, web series now. What is the difference you feel when you go from a TV set to like a web series? What? I'm sure there are some glaring differences.
Of course, I know what I'm doing on a web show because the script is already with me. I can at least prepare. I know the story from start to finish. I can build my graph of my character. And on a TV show, I really don't know. Till I go on the set sometimes, what scene are we doing? And even if I know that, I don't know that it's going to lead to something. So that's how uncertain a storyline of a television is.
Was that what made you like sort of take this jump to web series?
It is only that much you can explore on TV. So I've done lots of reality shows. I've posted, I've participated. Jassi, and then many other shows. There's nothing much more that you can explore now on TV. And like Gurdeep said, you know, you're never sure of the script. A good director in today's age in TV is about how many minutes he can shoot.
Absolutely.
Which is disappointing. When I did Jassi in 2003, it was about how well you shoot. It was about the quality of the product, right, which somewhere is out of the window these days.
We have a huge audience, right? Like, TV has a massive reach. Do you see pattern changing when it comes to TV audiences? Because is it a matter of what we are feeding them, or is it a matter of they wanting to see this content?
I feel it's a switch of the audience, yeah, because there is so much, so many other platforms. There is choice. You know, I don't have television, access to television. We have only a Fire Stick that we use, because even during lockdown, who's watching television? Everybody is hooked on to the web series. And even if you're missing out on something, you can get it online.
It's just that TV is too scared to explore. Mm-hmm. And the minute they try to explore, they only look at ratings for the first 2 weeks and decide the future of the show, which is not fair.
What is it like being a woman on a TV set, being a woman on a web series? Do you have more agency to sort of pitch in your ideas? Do you have more say?
Yeah, on both the platforms you have, you know, but I think we are experienced now. We have a body of work and we have proved ourselves. So, of course, it makes... And they wait. They wait for you to give your inputs.
I'm never scared to advise or suggest when it comes to a character that I'm playing.
With respect to, you know, what you as an actor should get in terms of money, do you think that is a better negotiating platform when it comes to web series and TV sort of just goes on to, you know, who is helming the story? That's what TV is all about. So do you think you're in a better position to negotiate when it comes to web series?
I think you have to be smart enough to negotiate anywhere and everywhere, because people will say that yaar yahan par budget kam hai. I have been always hearing this. So you just have to put that, you know, if you want me, it's going to be my way or the highway, and that is the only way it works. I've been hearing this for 20 years and I'm in the industry now. So you have to be smart enough.
You're doing TV, and if your show is a hit and if it is, it's been running for a longer time, longer period of time, you do end up making a lot of money, because actors like us, we usually get per days. So, and when we say yes for the TV show, we are obviously the lead character of the show. So the show revolves around us, and we end up shooting about 20 to 25 days, sometimes 27 days a month. So we do end up making more money on TV than on web series. Web series, you end up shooting for 45 days and you're done for, you know, those 7 episodes. And then season 2 and then season 3, if it works. So when it comes to money, I feel TV actors...
Television, yes. But if you see the per day, web is definitely, you know, the number of hours that you put in a day and you make money, web is definitely shelling out much more if you compare the two. Yes.
When we talk about TV, we've also seen this pattern of the credit period where, you know, you shoot today and then you know that you're going to be paid like 3 months ahead of that particular day. And this is like a thing that's become the normal in the industry. But talking about the situation right now, do you feel that this should change? Because people definitely need more cash. We've seen so many character actors, so many actors also who've not been paid their due since like the past 5-6 months. Do you think this is this is the time when sort of industry needs to come together and negotiate about this credit period, whether it's with the
broadcasters?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, I have some friends that there has to, and there is a very big rule and, you know, an agenda on this by Cinta. But it's very sad that actors, this clan has no unity. The junior actors, the technicians, even the IMPA has unity. Actors is the only, you know, tribe which has absolutely no unity. They don't stand for one another. They will give you shout outs, whatever. But when it comes to taking a stand for one another, there will never be anybody standing for you. They will be negotiating with the producer, ke main kam karta hun, mujhe le lo. There are a lot of my friends who were working, who have their ongoing show. Producers are not taking calls. They are saying, jab lockdown khulega, tab dekhenge. What do you mean? This agenda has to be chucked out properly by Cinta and IMPA together. And actors have to stand up, and there should be a petition going that producers really need to pay up people.
I think it's been a lovely chat. And
thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for doing this.